The NBC2 investigators are getting you results more than 2 years after we exposed licensed contractors not being held responsible for unfinished business. Lawmakers are changing the rules.
A bill making it easier to prosecute bad contractors is headed to the governor's desk for a signature. NBC2 investigator Rachel Polansky is here with what it means for victims of contractor fraud.
For future victims, this law will make it easier for them to get their money back if they're defrauded, and that's a really big deal. But for all of those people who have already lost money, well, this new law won't help much.
It's pretty emotional for me.
Each person.
Because it's all the money we had.
Shares a slightly different story.
It's a modern day stick up.
On and on and on.
You just don't have a gun.
About a licensed Southwest Florida contractor.
And how much money are you at a loss?
$220,000.
They were going to put a lien against my house.
Who took their money?
It's now approaching $90,000.
But didn't do the work.
It's unbelievable that people can take thousands upon thousands of dollars and walk free.
The NBC2 investigators began reporting.
Projects are constantly popping up.
Customers we've talked to.
Something has to be done.
What do you have to say to all the people you ripped off?
Over the last 2 years, you've watched the NBC2 investigators question law enforcement.
Why aren't police arresting these guys?
Attorneys.
Something's wrong.
Even the accused.
Mr. Cheney, there's a lot of people who say you took their money, didn't build their homes. Is there anything you want to say to these people?
Trying to find out why accused contractors rarely face criminal charges.
We've been trying to talk to you for over a year and a half
now. He's not going to make any comment.
The state attorney told us it's because the way the laws are written.
In many, many cases, we could not prove that the contractor committed theft because we couldn't prove they had the intent to take the money at the time or take it for their own use at the time they actually took it from the victim.
But all of that is about to change. After the NBC2 investigators exposed the issue in a series of reports, State Attorney Amira Fox and Representative Michael Grant teamed up to rewrite the statute.
Hopefully this bill, once it's passed, will move that needle and it will protect those who have been fraudulently taken advantage of by dishonest contractors.
And the key element the state attorney says she needed in order to prosecute just passed unanimously as part of a criminal justice reform bill.
Do you think this will finally make it easier for you to prosecute bad contractors who are allegedly ripping people off?
Absolutely. I mean, without a question, this will make it, I would go so far as to say, much easier for us to prosecute bad contractors who are ripping people off.
So if the governor signs this bill, a contractor will have to apply for permits within 30 days of being paid. Once those permits are issued, the contractor will have to start work within 90 days. And if those requirements are not met, a judge can rule that the contractor had intent to defraud.
And that's all new language.
That needed to happen so bad.
New language that Lynn LaBoudelier says could have saved her a lot of time and money.
We signed on July 25th of 2017. And they didn't apply for permits until December, and they didn't break ground until February. And it was slow going the whole time.
And even though this new legislation won't affect her personally because it's not retroactive, LaBoudelier says she's still glad she spoke up.
We want to make a difference.
Because she believes that all of the victims who shared their stories helped trigger this new legislation.
Hopefully it'll improve the building landscape in Florida throughout the whole state.
Once the governor signs this bill, which all my sources say that he will, the new language will become law on October 1st. For the NBC2 investigators, I'm Rachel Polansky.